Hello, good people. This is Edward Pai, and in today's video, we're going to kick off our series on robotics, computer vision, and reinforcement learning by taking a look at how to use the L298 and H-Bridge motor driver or motor controller. And in today's video, we're going to take a look at how to use this board without any microcontroller like an Arduino or Raspberry Pi, just so you can get to understand how the board works on its own. So that's it. Let's get started. Take you through the tools or equipment we need to complete this lesson or experiment, and we'll get started looking at the details of the board. So I have here a bench power supply, and what I also have on my table is I have this multimeter, and of course I have the board that we are going to talk about today. Now, if you're seeing this Raspberry Pi here, it is not because we are going to use the Raspberry Pi as part of the experiment, but I just want to show you the different types of motor controllers out there. So this one is coming from CamJam and is included in their robotics kit, and I like this particular motor controller because of how it sits well on the Raspberry Pi GPIOs. But essentially what you need are just the L298N motor controller, and you need some multimeter to measure things, and you also need a source of power, which can be a workbench power supply or power bank or even normal batteries. Okay, now let's start talking about the L298N motor driver or motor control board. And like I showed you previously, I said this board comes in multiple forms, and as you can see here, this is one from CamJam, and I mentioned that I like it because it fits nicely on your Raspberry Pi GPIO pins, and it also exposes the rest of the pins that it doesn't use, and so it has a very small form factor and it takes less space in your project. But then the connections and the way you control things are the same regardless of whether you are going with one that has this form factor or the most common one, which looks like this. And so whatever we learn in this video, even though we're going to focus on using this particular board, take notes when you see me using this particular board in the following videos, because I like to use it with a Raspberry Pi for obvious reasons that I have stated. Okay, so I'm going to take this out of the scene and we're going to focus entirely on this particular one, but the mechanics of control are the same. So okay, so what we have here is the L298N board. Okay, so if you turn the back, you will see the L298N board, and this is an H-Bridge motor controller. And I'm going to give you a theoretical explanation of how the board works before we move on to the practical session, where I will actually turn on the power supply and then show you everything that I've said to you in theory. Okay, so the board has two output ports. So you are able to control two different DC motors with this particular board. So you can have one motor here and you can have one motor connected also here. So when you're working with mobile robot base that you're going to control using differential drive mechanism, then you know this is a perfect board for you to go for. And this is where you put in your power, the supply voltage. Okay, so this is the positive side of it. If you look closely, I don't know if the camera is able to capture, but the first pin is a positive, and the middle is a ground, and we have this other pin here which I'm going to explain to you. Now the normal voltage that you can feed into this particular board ranges from 6 volts to 35 volts, but the recommended voltage is between 7 to 12 volts. And of course, the voltage that you put into the board determines what voltage gets out of the motor port, and so the power that goes to the motors that you are controlling as well. Now, on this board, there is this jumper right here, and there is this 5-volt voltage regulator also here. Now, what this 5-volt voltage regulator does is it takes some of the voltage that you feed into the board, and it uses it for its internal circuitry. So how the board works, I mean, there's this IC here, and so this 5-volt voltage regulator makes sure that there's 5-volt available on the board for its internal use. And if you have this jumper in place, like you can see, my jumper is fixed. If you have this jumper in place, what's going to happen is that if you measure the voltage between the ground and this pin, the 5-volt pin here, then of course you expect to see 5 volts between these nodes on the board. If you take this jumper out, then there's not going to be any 5-volt available to the board. So what you have to do is you have to supply your own 5-volt to the board to be used internally. But mainly the way we use it is we leave this jumper fixed, and then we put in the supply voltage in between these two nodes, okay? Now over here are about 6 pins. The first pin is enable A. The second pin is in 1, in 2, in 3, in 4, and enable B. So these motor port, this is output. I mean, on the board, they've labeled it out 2 and then out 3, but you can call it port A and port B as well. So what happens is, if you leave this jumper connected, then this port is enabled. And what it means is that you can control these two pins here, in 1 and in 2, to determine the direction of rotation of the motor connected to port A. In the same way, if you come to port B, we have the enable B button here, the jumper here. And what's going to happen is, if you leave the jumper connected, then this port is also enabled. And so you can use in 3 and in 4 to control the direction of rotation of the motor that is connected over here. Okay, so that is the main theory for you to understand about how this board works. Now I'm going to kick in the practical session, and then I'll show you how to actually use this board. Okay, so for the first practical thing, let's verify what I told you about what the jumper, the 5-volt jumper pin does on the board. So what I'm going to do is, I have turned on my bench power supply and the voltage is set to about 8 volts. So I'm going to measure the voltage that is actually going into the board right now. And mind you, I have also tapped from the 5-volt pin, which is the third pin here, and it's not connected to anything. We will use that later. Okay, so I'm going to measure the voltage at the input. And as you can see, the voltage is 7.93 volts, which is close to the 8 volts that I am supplying from the bench power supply. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take off the jumper, and then we will measure the voltage that comes out here. But before that, let's see what voltage is available between the ground and the 5-volt pin. So if I measure the voltage between the ground and the 5-volt pin, you can also see that the voltage is 4.98 volt, which is close to 5 volts. So now let's verify what I told you by taking off the jumper, and then we will measure the voltage between the ground and the 5-volt pin again. Okay, so indeed I have used this plier to get the jumper out of the board, and that is it here. So as you can see, the jumper is no more connected on the board, and that is why the LED on the board is not lit. So what this tells you is that there is no 5-volt available for the internal circuitry to use on the board. And let's go ahead to verify what I told you about what's going to happen between the ground and the 5-volt pin. So I'm going to measure the voltage between the ground and the 5-volt pin, and as you can see, it is 0 volt. So I'm measuring between these two terminals here, and as you can see, it is 0 volt. And the reason is because the 5-volt jumper has been taken off. And so if you want to use the board with this jumper off, then you have to manually supply 5-volt into the board. Let's put back the jumper and let's see what changes on the board. So I'm going to connect the jumper, and as you can see, the moment the jumper goes onto the board, the LED is lit again, and it means there's 5 volt available, and so we can go ahead to verify by measuring between these two, and you can see that yes, we have our 4.9 volt available. Okay, yep. Okay, so now we know the purpose of this 5 volt jumper, and we know the effect of taking it off, and also what changes on the board when you leave the jumper in place. Now the big question is, how do we control the port where the motors are actually going to be connected? Okay, and to do that, I am going to first of all start with you by measuring the voltage that is on each of the ports with their enable pins in place, and then I'll show you how you can control the power that goes out of each of the ports. So I'm going to start off by measuring the voltage between the port A terminals, and you can see that it is 0.18, that is zero volt. And I'm also going to measure the voltage on port B, and it's also 0.18. Now the question is, if the enable pins are in place, why don't we have enough voltage at the output to control the motors? And the reason is that the outputs, or the voltage that is available on each of the motor ports, is determined by the configuration of in one, in two, that is for port A, and in three, in four, for port B. So this is how it works. When you set in one high and in two low, then there is going to be enough voltage, and that voltage is going to be very close to the input voltage less what is dropped by the voltage regulator on the board. So you have that voltage available coming through the output port. And so if you do the configuration on in one and in two, that is, I mean, you set one high and you set the other low, then what's going to happen is there's going to be voltage available across the motor port so that the motor will start moving. Now, the direction of rotation of the motor determines which pin is set high and which pin is set low. So if you set pin one high and you set in two low, the direction is going to be different from when you set in one low and in two high. The same happens for in three and in four. Now this is where microcontrollers come in, but fortunately for us, we are not going to use a microcontroller today, because I want you to understand the board as a standalone unit. And so what we are going to do is, we are lucky enough to have this 5 volt available. Remember I said when you leave this this jumper pin connected, then there's 5 volt available on this pin here. And so we are going to use the 5 volt to simulate what microcontrollers do. Because basically, if you're using an Arduino or Raspberry Pi to control this board, what you're going to do is to set the pin either high or low to determine the direction of rotation. And also, I want to mention that the speed of the rotation of the motor is determined by the input voltage, or you can also use PWM signals to control how fast they move. And that is going to be another topic for another video. So now with this pin here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set in one high. Okay, so I'm going to set in one high by connecting the 5 volt pin to in one. Now let's go ahead to measure the voltage across the outputs of the motor port A. So you can see that now we have negative, let me brighten the screen so you see it well. We have negative 7.62 volts. And like I said, the voltage that comes out of the motor port is going to be close to the input voltage, less what is dropped by the voltage regulator. And that is why I am putting in 8 volts and I'm getting 7.6 volts out. And mind the negative symbol on the voltage reading on the multimeter. That means the voltage, or the polarity, is reversed. And so what it means is that if there is a motor connected there, then the motor is going to move in a reverse direction. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I set pin in one high over here, and that is when we got a negative 7.6 volts. So I'm going to set in two high, and then it's going to leave in one low, and let's see what happens to that same motor port that we measured, which is port A. So I connect, this time it is in two that is high, and in one is rather low. So let's go ahead and measure the voltage across these two terminals. I have reversed the terminals of my multimeter, sorry. So I'm going to measure it here, And now you can see that the negative sign is gone. So we have 7.8 volt across. So this is how you reverse the direction of the motor. The direction of rotation of the motor is determined by which of the two pins is high. So you can set in one high, in two low, or in one low, in two high, and that is going to change the direction of rotation of the motors. Okay, now let's go on to the motor port B. And it is the same operation. So if I set in three high, then now when I come and I measure the voltage across that port, that motor port, you can see that there is 7.82 volts available on that port. And note the polarity. Now I am going to change the pin that I set high. So I'm going to set in four high instead of in three, and then I will come here and I will measure the voltage. So I'm going to measure, and you can see that now we have negative 7.63 volt, which shows that the polarity has been reversed, and hence the motor is going to rotate in the opposite direction. So this is basically all that you need to understand about this board, and we have had this practical session where we've used a multimeter to verify what we learned theoretically. Now it is time for us to connect the motor and actually see it in operation. Okay, so now I have connected a DC motor to the output A of the motor controller board, and I'm going to control the direction of rotation using in one and in two, because those are the pins that controls what happens on the output port. Now, mind you, my motor has 6 wires, and the reason is because it has an encoder, which I will also talk about in a future video. And what the encoder does is to help us to measure precisely the RPMs of the motor so that we can use PID to help the robot to move in a straight direction. But that is a story for another video. And so what you basically want to do is, if you have a DC motor, like these regular DC motors, just connect your wires to the pins on the DC motors and connect them to the port. For me, I usually say the how you do the connection doesn't really matter, because if you find out that it is rotating in the opposite direction, it's just about you reversing the configurations of in one and in two to get it to move in the right direction that you want. So ignore these extra four wires here. They are for the magnetic encoder at the bottom of my geared motor, but the objective is to show you how we can actually control the direction of rotation of this motor. So what I'm going to do is, I have my 5 volt here, which I'm going to use to drive in one high. And so if I drive in one high, you can see that the motor is moving in this direction. And if I want it to move in the opposite direction, what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to set in one low by taking the 5 volt out of it, and I'll set in two high. And now you can see that the motor is moving in this direction. So ladies and gentlemen, this is how you control DC motors using the L298N H-bridge motor controller. And it is so easy to understand, and it's a very important thing for you to know as a roboticist. So thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.